Don't you hate it when that happens to you? When it does, you need this and this and this. When it happens to me, I always know where to go. When you've got professionals on your side, your problems don't stand a chance. What are you waiting for? Contact them today and let them take care of your problems.
Today, I want to speak to you about this country called America. America, land of the free, home of the brave. The country where Rambo, Rocky, Hulk Hogan, Donald Trump, where these great icons of our time, they come, where change. Yes, I can. Yeah, I'll spy on your emails and, you know, it's such a great country, such a great nation that has all the nuclear bombers, all the nuclear bombs, all the warships, all the tanks, all the military power, but doesn't have the capacity to take care of its citizens where sickness is concerned. So today I thought I would speak to you on the land of the free. In like Indians say, land of the free. For those Western expats who don't know what is land, please refer some Indian guy to ask, what is land? Land, L-U-N-D, land. So I'll tell you why today this Indian passport, Indian, eating with the hand, Indian, okay. Why this Indian guy decided to talk about the land of the free, home of the brave, and land of bobs and vegin. I'll tell you why. Now, this guy, what's his name? Joe Biden, the presidential hopeful. He's standing for elections. Every presidential year, or it's when elections are going to take place, every once in 4 years, whenever there is a presidential candidate or something, this one narrative that keeps repeating itself. The candidate will stand for elections. Everything will be fine. Then somewhere down the line, almost every candidate, male, will have, he sexually assaulted me. He sexually raped me. He sexually this, he sexually that. Okay, I can understand we men like to shag women or whatever. But what I don't understand is, all the years, they're okay. There is no claim for sex or rape or sexual assault. All the years, there is nothing. But the minute they stand for elections, the minute they stand for office, suddenly these women from somewhere, they wake up. I got raped. I got sexually assaulted. Oh no, he touched my poo-poo. He touched my pom-pom. Suddenly they wake up. And suddenly they come out with sexual assault, sexual rape, sexual this, sexual that. And okay, I can understand that women need to come forward and... But now here's, I'll give you perspective. Just think about what I'm saying, huh? Now, if I were to ask you, listen, man, 27 seconds ago, what did you do? It's very easy. You'll be like, 30 seconds. Okay, 27 seconds. I did this. I was walking, same thing. Then if I ask you 27 minutes ago, what did you do? You'll think back, okay, half an hour, I was doing this. Then I tell you 27 days, that's nearly a month ago. You'll think, month ago, okay, this is May. April, what was I doing? Okay. And then I tell you, 27 weeks, there you will start to struggle. 27 weeks ago, what did I do? 27 weeks. You'll start thinking, shit, yeah, 27 is 6 months ago, nearly. What was I doing? And then if I ask you 27 months ago, you'll be like, fuck, that's 1 year and 3 months. What did I do? 1 year, 3 months. Does anyone remember? Now see the fun. I asked you about 27 seconds, 27 minutes, 27 hours, 27 days, 27 weeks, 27 months. As it goes longer, it becomes harder. Now if I ask you 27 years ago, what did you do 27 years? Imagine, 30 years ago. Do you remember what you did 30 years ago? Does anybody remember what they did 30 years ago? I, for the life of me, can't remember what some of the details of, like, just a week ago. I find it very hard to remember. In fact, sometimes if someone tells me their name, I forget within the next few seconds. Okay? I find it very hard to remember things. And you're asking me to remember something that happened 27 years ago. This is Joe Biden's, that case, that lady, 27 years ago, Joe Biden did something. Now, who the fuck remembers 27 years ago? What the fuck are you talking, man? So for 27 years, maybe someone fingered your vagina. So after 27 years, shit, he fingered my vagina. Ooh, I feel the tingling sensation now. Fucking your cobwebs must be so many there. There must be a spider sitting in your vagina. What the fuck is wrong with people here? And this only happens in the West, and especially, case in point, US, where all the nonsense, you know, all the absolute utter nonsense takes place. It's like, instead of having, you know, people using freedom for the right purpose, they are all using for absolutely the wrong purpose. It's like India, but India that is more modern. It's even worse. I'll give you another example. This thing about guns. What the fuck do you need guns for? Oh, to protect ourselves. It's the First Amendment. Yeah, that is why you have kids shooting other kids. That's why you have these mental cases who are taking guns and storming the legislative assembly. Oh, we want to go to work, so we'll take the guns. We'll show we are big. Oh, we'll hold the guns. Yeah, here, let me give you a perspective. If a black man were to hold those guns, you'd fucking shoot them to death. White man can hold a gun, nobody says anything. And you're talking of the most modern nation, the greatest nations. The amount of apartheid, the amount of racism that was there is the greatest in countries like USA. You don't have to have any doubt, just go through history. How did the whites treat the blacks? This kind of fucking slavery that is there. Okay, let's forget all this. Let's look at information by itself. You have Republicans, you have Democrats. Each one gives you a narrative with so much of evidence and reason. And the other side does the same. Now you don't know who to listen to, you don't know who to believe. And then they'll tell you, yeah, that is the beauty of America. We give you, yeah, the problem is you're giving so much of information, you're confusing people. You're creating a solid divide. For example, can you give me one thing that everyone agrees on? No. This COVID-19, this virus. One side is saying, oh, it's manufactured by Bill Gates because he has the patents for that. On the other side, you have Dr. Rashid saying, oh, this was Fauci's political game. You have Fauci saying, no, you have to get vaccine done. Then you have people who say, no, vaccination is good. Other side saying vaccination is bad. Then you get people, okay, if you think that is confusing enough for a country that boasts about good information and good things, tell me, fast food industry, how many of these companies are sponsoring, politicians? This food pyramid for eating food, where you have the biggest chunk, all the carbohydrates, which today has been proved is dangerous for health. Which country has marketed that cornflakes, sugary syrups, eating even the chocolate, you know, the chocolate spread, that is good for health? Which is the most unhealthy fucking country in the world, where maximum obesity, maximum heart problems, you know, maximum unhealthy lifestyle? Which country? Okay, you're talking of them being modern. diabetic medicines, okay, basic medicines that will help you save your life. They are, the prices are just shooting up. Now, you're talking of US, they are talking of these ventilators and this thing which are costing millions. How is it in poor countries they are able to do it for less than $1? See, these are questions to be asked. The problem with America or the entire, you know, constitution of US is we are superior. We are great. We are the greatest nation. Our flag, this is a fact. The US flag during Olympics or anything, every other country's flag, you know, just marks down out of respect for the hosting country, except US. Why? What's so great about your country? What's so fucking great that you're a self-appointed policeman? And if you were a fair player, if you were honest, I can understand. Where there is money and where there is power, there is corruption. Why do you think US attacks those countries which have oil? And then after it attacks those countries to free them, give them freedom, democracy or whatever shit, they put their own puppet over there. All the oil contracts come only to US. All the vendors are mostly US. Everything is US. So, what is so great? What's so great about all this? Just bullshit, man. See, and the world has realized that it's all bullshit. That is why today, nobody gives a damn. Nobody gives a damn about US. See, Russia and China. See, India. They are playing a game. It's all a game of politics. I'm not saying that Russia, China and India are any better. No, all the countries are the same. To tell you honestly, all the countries are the same. But this, I'm mightier than you. I'm greater than you. That's fucking bullshit. Where America prides itself of freedom and this and that. If you start giving mental cases, people with personality disorders and lack of maturity, you start giving them power and freedom. It's like having 20 children in your house, children, small kids, and you give them total freedom to do whatever they want, express whatever they like. There'll be fucking chaos. You need to have a stick to give them, to create that fear, so they can be disciplined. I know what you'll say. Oh, so you recommend a tyrant or a dictatorship. Yes, sometimes that may be required for people with less brains, with, you know, something mentally wrong up there. You need. See, if you're talking about democracy, what the fuck? Look at the mess US is in. All this big talk about freedom and expression and this. They can't even save their own citizens from death. They don't even have a uniform policy. They don't even agree on simple basic things like science. Even there it is politicized. Even there it is. It's a game. It's so much shit. And if you think US is truly free, just Google search what is the Patriot Act. They're spying on everyone. Everybody is spying on everyone. Everyone's trying to act like they're holy. It's all bullshit, man. See, America, like every other country, likes to show we are the greatest. Seoul does it. Russia does it. India does it. Pakistan does it. We are the greatest country in the world. You speak to a nationalistic extremist, my country is the greatest. It's like my cock is the biggest. Fine. Where, that's where it stops. Where it comes to doing good, where it comes to helping mankind, that takes a backseat. Because they all want to show my dick is big. It's the biggest dick in the world. It's the best dick in the world. So that's where it comes down to, and that's where it stays. USA, USA, USA. It's like people are, India, India, India. What the fuck? If it helps you have a better life, if it's doing good for the community, it's helping other people, fine. Nothing to say. But the way it's going, it's a fucking mess. The reason I brought up this video was after seeing the mental retardation of this. Another election. Oh, he's sexually something. It's like this Indian comedian who, he took this girl for having sex. I can't get his name, yeah, that he is an Indian origin, can't get his name. So he took this girl for having sex. So when he put her on the kitchen table and he went to give her oral sex to lick her vagina, it seems when he started to do that, that time she felt uncomfortable and she, stop licking my poom poom. And she went away. So he was covered with all this vagina stuff. He felt very bad. Okay, he washed himself. She later on filed a, what? Sexual crime, sexual assault, rape. He forced me into it. So you went, smooched case, went to his apartment, everything was okay. And suddenly, he didn't lick your vagina properly, so you felt uncomfortable. And that's where, that point you felt, oh, he was forcing you. Until then, it was okay. That's the kind of country and that's the kind of place where people do all this shit. Like, Epstein died because of suicide. Suicide. Bill Clinton, they are such an innocent family. Obama was truly a great leader. He brought about so much change. And Donald Trump. That's how Prime Minister Modi pronounced his name. He's a great president. So, you know, it's like watching these reality shows. It's rubbish. It offers no value. But you watch it because, like, okay, let this take my mind out of all this shit. So you guys tell me, what do you think? Do you think I'm wrong? Do you think I'm right? Do you think America is truly the land of the free, the home of the brave, the greatest nation in the world, the greatest country, where people can sue each other's brains for every single thing? He hurt my feelings. Oh, he hurt my feelings. Oh, I'm transgender. Oh, I'm gender fluid. Today I feel like a boy. Tomorrow I feel like a girl. Oh, that kind of country where you offend my feelings. You offend my feelings. So let me know, what do you think of this topic? It's not me to hate Americans or anything. And yeah, before you do go, Amazon makes billions. Facebook makes billions. Churches make millions. But they never have to pay a single tax. But the poor people have to. So, just tell me, what do you think of all this? Love to hear your views. This is me signing off for now. Take care.